everybody! What's up? My name is Rachel Kipp. Welcome to my channel. Today I have another gaming community spotlight channel for you guys. I know it's been a while, but I've been trying to record with this person who I'm interviewing today. But our schedules didn't really work out for a very long time. He was actually supposed to be the first person I interviewed for this series, but it turns out that we're just now getting around to it, so... This guy is a very strange guy. He says some very strange things, and he has a very strange YouTube name. But anyway, please welcome RyoSmizHi4.
I'd just like to say one thing and one thing only. This is my sole purpose of YouTube, pretty much. I'd just like to say geology will not stop me from sexual intercourse with my fans, okay? Okay, now that we've cleared that out of the way, take it away.
Do you see what I mean?
Bada bing, bada boom.
Do you see what I mean about saying strange things? Okay.
Yeah, that's all my stamina. I'm pretty tired now. I'm done.
Wow.
I'm
done. I have all these questions for you, though.
Yeah, bye, Rachel.
Wow, come back. Come back. Come back here right now. You're not going to screw this up for me, okay? I mean,
no,
you.
No.
You. Yeah, okay. So, are you ready for these awesome questions that I have for you?
How may I pleasure you, my treasure?
Okay, so...
That was supposed to be something from The Office, but I messed it up.
Just oh, well, you messed everything up, so...
Yeah.
Anyways, first question is, what made you want to do YouTube?
It just seemed like it was something fun. I just wanted to explore its bodies and exploits, and its bodies, since it's obviously a person and several people, because it's plural.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, I just saw some, you know, commentators around the block, the Nanners Man, Penguin Zero, people like that, and I just got inspired and bored, because this is Midwest. Nothing to do.
I gotcha. When did you start making videos?
I'm pretty sure about 2.5 years ago, maybe, probably around the 2-year mark. I'm actually on my channel right now checking. Yeah, I think around 2 years. It was in 2010.
Damn.
And, yeah.
That's a long time.
Rocking and rolling since.
And you have almost 400 videos, right?
Almost. 389. I'm going to go with that number. Just a guesstimate.
Man, what a no
393.
Life.
Get on my level.
393? Dang. Are you going to do a 400th video special?
Yeah, you bet your sweet pancakes I am.
Pancakes are gross. Okay,
I hate them. In the club.
So, okay. When did you get your partnership?
About 2 months ago.
Why did you get your partnership?
Custom thumbnails.
Duh.
It took me countless hours to make them, and if you check my channel, you know, they're actually not too good, but, you know, if you didn't know, when you get the partnership, you actually have to go back to every individual video and change the settings to get revenue, and also you have to change the thumbnail for every single one, and that's actually quite a bit of work. People don't really take into account how hard it is making videos, and it is actually quite a mouthful.
It is an adventure, I will say. Especially if you have a slow computer and or a slow internet connection.
Yeah, that's how I started out, and I just recently, I guess you can say, stepped up from that. It's really not that big of a upgrade, but it's definitely better, and it's helping me out a lot.
Computer-wise?
I just need new internet, and we should be good to go.
Nice. Yeah, because didn't you say it took you, like, 3,000 minutes to upload something the other day?
Yes.
How long was that video?
15 minutes.
Dang, that is a long time.
Saying something right there.
Yeah, that's really slow internet. Jeez, God. Okay, moving on with questions, I suppose. What was the inspiration for your YouTube username, if you had?
Oh, man. I really don't know. Maybe it was just one day when I was playing with cereal, you know, like the alphabet cereal.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it came up with R-Y-O, and I went on from there. But it actually kind of has letters for my name, and 4 was just a random ass number because RyoSmiz was originally taken by my old channel, which was god awful, and I had to close for several reasons, but it sucked anyway, so it's not really that big of a loss. It just kind of blew ass, like complete ass. It's horrible.
What do you mean, like how?
I was one of those guys that just got like a crappy camera, put in front of a TV, and did some Let's Play.
Oh!
That was one of those. So.
Wait, why did you not just, like, delete all your videos?
Because I'm stupid.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Okay, wow. Okay, why should people watch your videos, Ryo?
Let's see here. Because my nipple fluids are just very entertaining to listen to, because they produce sound, I guess.
Is that what you were sucking out of your shirt earlier?
Yeah, that's what I do. I generate milk. I don't even generate milk. I generate soda from those wee beasties. And, see, I don't know. I just skip, you know, the beginning stuff, all the slow stuff, and I just go right to the climax and everything I publish on my channel. Uh-huh. I think it's pretty entertaining, my personal opinion, but I wouldn't really know that since, let's just put it this way, not many people have told me if I've done good or bad, which I guess works out for both cases, because if I'm a complete utter failure, I just don't know yet.
Well, I haven't watched many of your videos, but I do go to some of your live streams, and it's decently entertaining. Well, okay, more than decently entertaining. You're pretty entertaining. Yeah. I like watching your live streams. It's funny, like, the funniest part, I think, is, like, when you mess up and you start squeaking.
Yeah, I squeak just a little bit. I mean, I'm not 12 or nothing. Because on my streams, it's really weird. The audio quality is crap, and it makes me sound like I'm 8, while on YouTube, it makes me sound like I'm 12. So that's kind of an improvement there, even though in real life, I'm 16. But yeah. My voice isn't, it's actually gotten a lot deeper if you look at my old videos, which I don't even want to talk about, because I sound like Mickey Mouse or... horrible.
That's gross. It's just, I'm just kidding.
Disgusting.
I'm just kidding. Oh yeah, I had to add in a question about your Twitch stuff. When did you start, like, live streaming?
I'd have to say about half a year ago, maybe. I started off small, probably did it once a week, but now I'm stepping up from anywhere to 1 to 7 times as much. The first week that I actually got it running, like XSplit and everything good to go, I streamed every day for about 3 hours, and that I was pretty tired at the end of the week. It was fun, though. It was fun. Not too many people in the crowd, but as long as I'm entertaining one person, mission complete right there.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly what it's all about. It's not about really... I was talking to somebody on Twitter today, and they were asking me, like, how I got my channel to be so successful, and basically I told them, help from friends and a lot of hard work. And I told them that they just have to remember that when they are making videos, that their purpose shouldn't be, you know, view count. Like, that should not be their main goal. Their main goal should be to entertain the subscribers that they have, make sure they're content, make sure, like, they are happy, but not don't let them dictate your channel. Like, I know that Only Use Me Blade had a tweet the other day that I saw that was, listen to your subscribers, but don't let them dictate your content.
Mm-hmm.
So, just some pretty good tips, I suppose.
You know, the thing is, you want to have fun with it. That's the whole point. And if you're not having fun, then you might as well just let shit hit the fan. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes, make sure you're having fun, and make sure that, you know, the people that watch your videos are also having fun. Because,
yes.
I don't know. It's both ways, I suppose.
Yes.
All right, so next question. What games do you play, and what games do you have, like, planned for the future, if you have any?
Well, I'm actually a very diverse channel. I don't really have one genre that I really stick to. I just... go with the flow and whatever I feel like doing at the moment, I usually do. I have actually several series going on right now, and what I plan to do in the future is when I get my cap card, I plan to do some, I'm not so going to say stations, but like, what's the name of the stations? The Xbox?
Consoles?
And, oh, console there games. You go. Yeah, I plan to do some originals like Halo and stuff right now, like that. Man, I'm just getting mumbled. But I'm actually starting a whole new series, not really that new, but it's about a couple weeks, maybe a month at the most, where I'm doing retro stuff once a week.
Ooh.
And it's longer than just average. It's usually towards the 30 to hour mark, and right now I'm doing Super Mario 64.
Nice. Very nice.
Yeah.
Are you using an emulator for that right now?
Yes. But for all you anti-pirate people out there, I actually have the game purchased on the Nintendo 64. I just have not gotten a capture card.
Yeah, and it's weird because I don't know if you could capture Nintendo 64 footage.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I know, yeah, with my PVR, like, I have to, I think I plugged the Xbox directly into it. So I don't know if you could plug a Nintendo 64 directly into it, but I never had a 64. I had an NES, and I didn't know how it worked because I was five, so.
I just press these buttons.
Shut up, just like, blowing the cartridge. Up. Like, do you remember that? Like, clean the dust out of the cartridge.
Yeah, good times. And it does. It says directly on the back of the cartridge, do not blow inside this device. And everybody did that. Same with the Game Boy.
Yeah, I know. And, like, still today, like, if I'm playing, like, a Game Boy game, like a Game Boy Advance game or anything like that, if it's not working, then I take it out and I, like, blow in the cartridge.
Please, Spawn
Oh,
Rachel.
My God. I just, it's a habit, okay? I'm sorry.
Yeah, same here.
Alright, so, what is your favorite thing about making videos?
I just love ejecting oodles of fun into my fans' atmosphere of air, I guess.
Okay, continue.
It's pretty much just the experience and the relationships I make on the way. I've met some great people for the most part, mm-hmm. and I've got to reunite with friends from my Cali days, because I've moved several times, and just to be able to talk to them, because I usually don't talk to them outside of Skype and stuff like that, it was loads of fun.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Okay, that's a very good reason for that's a very good favorite thing, I suppose. And my last question is, what are your goals? Like, what are your short-term goals and your long-term goals? Like, involving YouTube, mostly, but okay. I guess maybe outside.
Not life?
Yeah,
life
just
too.
Life in general, if you want to, you know, tell us some of your life goals.
Okay, I just plan to keep doing what I'm doing right now. Hopefully I can get a bit more bigger of a fan base, but I just want to keep meeting new people, keep producing content, and I'll just pretty much take it from there. I'm just having fun with it. It's not something you want to rush or have certain benchmarks for, because if you don't make those, then it makes you kind of sad and not have fun. So I just want to keep doing what I'm doing. And life, I really have no idea what I really want to do, other than I just had this feeling when I was younger, and right now it's definitely getting more serious since I'm coming to age. I've always wanted to enroll in the army, actually, and I plan to do that when I'm older for several personal reasons, not for just, you know, killing people, but I just have some personal reasons about it. Like, my grandpa a long time ago, he was in the army too, and I just want to fill the boots.
Okay.
Stuff like that. But towards YouTube, just want to keep doing what I'm doing.
Alright, cool.
What about you? I'm just kidding.
This is not about me. This interview is not about me. Are you kidding me right
I am going to throw a wild card in here. I'm going to turn this thing around. It's going to be interviewing you.
Nope. Turn it back around. Turn it back around right now.
Okay.
Okay. So, yeah. That's all the questions that I have for today. Maybe we should do a series sometime.
I don't know. I'm going to have to look at my... Okay.
You're such a jerk.
Schedule's pretty booked.
Alright, well, thank you for letting me interview you and whatnot, and playing Counter-Strike with me. By the way, you've been watching Counter-Strike. I have some funny clips at the very end of this after the splash screen, so...
Of me pwning you, am I right?
No, no. Yeah. I got you a couple of times.
Couple, that's a key word. Be the leaf, just remember that.
Be the leaf, be the leaf. Alright, thanks for tuning in, guys, and look out for the next one. You have any last words, by the way?
Nope.
Okay, that's it.
Check you later, hopefully. I think you're on a different pistol than me.
I right-clicked and I put a silencer on my gun.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely a different gun. Oh, yeah, it's the USPP or something. Yeah, whatever. What? I'm going in for the kill. I don't even care.
I'm going in.
Stop. That is a barrel. Gonna make your move?
What move? I ran away.
Or did you? Wow!
No!
Wow. That was some high class playing right there. Never would have expected that. Did that work out?
Hold on.
What? You canoe full of shit, you! Come for you. I don't even care if it explodes. I'm just gonna kill you. Cause that's America.
Holy
I'm the Dark Knight. Okay. Oh, cool! I didn't buy a defusal kit, so I guess it's just happy going for now. Oh, I can still defuse it. Oh, no, I can't defuse it. Or what? What? It's letting me. It says I can't defuse it without a defusal kit, but I'm defusing it. Okay, cool.
Your body just went flying.
Defusing it. Okay, cool.
Your body just went flying.